Hi, I'm Javed. Welcome to 5-minute class on principal stress. Before going to principal stress, let us understand stress. Stress is an internal resisting force developed within the body when a load is applied. So load divided by area gives stress. When the stress fails the body, the stress developed in the body is known as failure stress. This is a unique property of the material. But in reality, our bodies are very random in nature, with different direction of the loading and different magnitude of the loading. How to predict this body is going to fail with what stress? Let us consider a small space in the body. So the stresses developed in the component are sigma x, sigma y, tau xy. Sigma x, sigma y are normal stresses, tau xy are shear stresses. So the body is going to fail based on the combination of these stresses. Now let us understand what will be the combination of the stress that is causing the failure. So the maximum of this combination of stresses occurs on one arbitrary plane. Let us say the arbitrary plane is making an angle theta with respect to vertical. Now resolve these stresses onto this arbitrary inclined plane. Say the normal stress occurring on this inclined plane is sigma, and the shear face which is acting along the face is tau, that is shear stress. So from the basic mathematics, you can resolve these stresses on this inclined plane which is making an angle theta with vertical. So no need to remember this formula, but you can see this normal stress and shear stress are function of theta. So at certain angle of theta, this normal stress is maximum. Similarly, at certain angle of another theta, this shear stress is maximum. To find when this shear stress or normal stress are maximum, you need to differentiate both the equations with theta and equate it to zero. Let us do that. First, I took the normal stress on the inclined plane, differentiated with the theta. I got the theta value, that is angle of inclination value, and back substitute it. I'll get maximum and minimum values of the normal stress. Similarly, take shear stress on inclined plane, differentiate with the theta and equate it to zero. You will get two values of theta that indicates the plane on which maximum or minimum shear stress occurs, and back substitute this theta value, you will get maximum and shear stress values. So these maximum shear stress and the previous slide maximum normal stress are nothing but your principal stresses. So these are going to govern the failure condition of your component. So by using failure theories, you can predict exactly when this body is going to fail. The same derivation you can obtain from the Mohr circle. Mohr circle is nothing but a graphical representation of the principal stresses. We can cover it in the next topic. Hope you have understood the topic. Thanks for watching. Share it if you liked it.